For you to become a responsible driver, you need to learn the traffic signs and pavement markings that are present in the roadway. Traffic signs are classified into three. One is regulatory signs, two is warning signs, and the last one is guide or informative signs. So in our discussion, atong binagsaon ang mga signs under sa regulatory, mga signs under sa warning signs, o ang mga signs under sa informative or guide signs. Ang regulatory signs are signs that inform road users of traffic laws and regulations which, if disregarded, will constitute an offense. Muna katong mga signs nga mo'y makaingon nga ang usa ka driver mapinalize or matagan o fines for the violation. Regulatory sign is very different from warning sign or informative sign as far as giving of penalty is concerned. Because violation of the regulatory sign means a penalty, while violation or not taking heed on the warning or informative sign will not cause any penalty at all. So, unang klase ng regulatory sign, kaning ginatawag na tuog, priority sign, such as stop sign. Driver must stop at designated stop line, no parking within 6 meters. So usually, makita ni mo ni sa mga dagko nga series ang stop nga sign. Let's say for example, diya ka dapat mo stop para mag-load sa imuha nga or mag-unload sa imuha nga passengers, so makita ni mo ni nga sign. Or give way sign, yield to vehicles on right side of intersection. Another type of regulatory sign is the direction signs. These signs indicate the only direction in which the motorist is obliged to follow. So you can see in your screen, no turns, two-way sign, one-way sign, keep right or traffic, merging traffic, and the other forms of direction signs. So if in case kaninga direction is violated or not heeded by a particular driver, so meaning kinahanglan nga mapenalize siya o natagaan siya o penalty for violating the sign. Another type of regulatory sign is kaning ginatawag og prohibitive or restriction signs. These signs indicate the only direction in which the motorist is obliged to follow, which is also the same or similar to the previous one. So you can see on your screen signs such as no entry, no buses, no jeepneys, no motorcycles, no animal drawn vehicles, no push carts, no vehicles with trailer. Mo ni mga example nga sign. Usually, ang prohibitive or restriction sign is circular in shape, tapos na ay naka-diagonal nga color nga red, which symbolizes the prohibition for the entrance of any type of vehicles as reflected on the sign. So kung, for example, kani mo nakitan, so meaning ang tanan nga cars, dili pwede nga mosulod nga area. Pero usually, bisan pag naani nga sign, naapagoy uban nga drivers nga gahi kay ulo nga magpawalang bisa rawa, urag wala nakikita sa sign, mudirit sa Japan o paturato yung sulod ang nga direction. So kung masakpan, pwede siyang ma-penalize o matagan o fine. Another signs are no pedestrian crossing. Pedestrians are not allowed to cross the road. Use overpass or use pitching. Pedestrians must use the overpass or pedestrian crossing. No right turn or no left turn. Vehicles are not allowed to turn left or right. No U-turn. Vehicles are not allowed to make a U-turn. And no overtaking zone. Ang no overtaking zone, usually makita ni mo ni sa intersection. Sometimes also makita ni mo ni siya sa university, college, or elementary or high school premises sa mga eskwelahan. Okay? So, makita ni mo nga dili allowed ang usa ka action once na ang kaninga diagonal line nga red. Okay? Sunod, speed signs. Ang speed signs are also regulatory signs. Maximum speed restriction from 60 to 100. End of speed restriction, minimum speed restriction. So these are the signs that will regulate as to the allowable maximum speed in a particular highway. Next is parking signs. Parking signs, allowable parking and loading zone at a given time and place. So makita nimo ni sa different municipalities and cities. Let us say for example, ang unang figure 3, 1 hour meter parking or loading zone or loading and unloading zone, no stopping anytime or no waiting anytime. These are usually the signs nga common kayo sa municipalities and cities, yet these are also the signs that are always neglected by a lot of drivers. Bisag nakabutang na og no waiting anytime o parkingan paguna sa atbang, o bisag nakabutang ang bawal maghintay anumang oras ang vehicle, o either ipark sa luyo o ipark sa atubangan. So pag makita ni, I hope you as current or future licensed drivers should take notice and follow the signs, because these signs are meant to reduce traffic or congestion in a highway or roadway. Additional regulatory signs are the following: bus PUG stop zone, PUG stop zone. We also have bus stop zone, no parking throwaway zone, no parking anytime from Monday to Friday, right turner cross at broken lines. So these are also regulatory signs that if not followed by motorists can lead to penalty or fines. So dali ra kayo ang pagsabot ani kay kung makita ka na nakabutang nga P tapos gisirkulan ang letter P, then gibutangan og red nga diagonal, buti pasabot, di ka pwede nga mo park ana nga area. Okay? So kung sa above sa letter P na nakabutang og bus PUG stop, buti pasabot, parking is not allowed on that particular zone. Also, we have miscellaneous signs as part of the regulatory signs. Let us say, no entry for vehicles with gross axle load of more than 2 tons. No entry for vehicles with more than 100 meters in length. Okay? No entry for vehicles with 3.5 meters in height. Okay, kung musulod yun ka, may posible nga masangko ang vehicle. Use seatbelt. Signs is used for someone to RA 8750, the seatbelt law. Be aware of children crossing. No entry for vehicles with gross vehicle mass of more than 5 tons. No entry for vehicles with more 2 meters of width. No blowing of horns. Be aware of pedestrian crossing, bike lane ahead, and be aware of persons with disabilities and disabilities crossing. These are also miscellaneous signs that are part of the regulatory signs. Again, if ang regulatory signs are not followed by a motorist, ang mitabuan eh, mapenalize ka or magbayad ka sa imong violation. The second general classification of traffic signs is what we call as warning signs. These are signs used to warn motorists of potentially hazardous conditions on or adjacent to the road. It advises motorists of road conditions that require caution and may call for a reduction in speed in the interest of safety and that of other road users. So, ang warning sign is again different from regulatory sign, because warning sign is just a sign that will give you caution, okay? Or will give you warning on a imminent danger ahead of the roadway. So, mabalaan ni mo nga warning sign isa, because usually, ang warning sign, ang shape ani niya is triangle, right? So, say for example, horizontal signs. These signs are used to indicate the type of road curb ahead. These signs are used to indicate the type of road curb ahead of the motorist. So, layo padaan, nakabutang na niya mga sign to warn the motorist kung unsa ang forma sa dalan. For example, sharp turn. Okay, kung ikaw sharp turn, ang pagliko nimo dapat diretso, right? Sharp ang pagliko. Dili kay mo curve pa ka. Sunod, reverse turn or curve nga highway, or reserve or reverse curve, or winding road, paliko-liko, or hairpin bend. So paglantaw nimo ani sa roadway nga nakita nimo ni nga sign, sumunod so, maghatag nimo og warning on what is the possible geographical feature of the highway ahead. So paglantaw nimo nga naay nakabutang nga winding road, buti pasabot sa unahan nga ana mag-amping ka kay paliko-liko ang dalan. So kung imong gi-ignore kaning mga warning signs, there's a big possibility that you will end up being in a accident. Sunod, intersection signs. You can also see intersection ahead sign, T junction sign, Y junction ahead, roundabout ahead or rotunda. Unsay buti pasabot ang rotunda? Pag sulod nimo, motoyo ka. Right? Motoyo ka usab mo exit or side road junction ahead, approach to intersection, approach to intersection side road or approach to intersection merging traffic. So mo kuno mga sign nga makita nimo, that will also illustrate the possible geographical feature of the roadway ahead. The next type of warning sign is kaning ginatawag og road with signs. For example, we have road narrows ahead, meaning gikan sa dako nga dalan ni paggamay ang saunahan, okay? Narrow bridge ahead, end of two-way road ahead, two-way road ahead. So muna maghatag nimo warning. For example, kung ang sa unahan nga dalan mo gamay, okay? From four lanes, may mo siyang two lanes, so ang road width signs pwede siyang gibutang before sa narrow nga road. We also have road obstacle signs. We have opening bridge ahead, uneven road ahead, hump ahead, downhill sign, uphill sign, spillway sign, flood prone area, landslide prone area, slippery when wet, animal crossing ahead, and low flying airplane zone. So, kaniya mga warning signs, again, will be installed a distance, a considerable distance away from the actual geographical location. Okay? Kay kung ang driver, baguanay pa sa usa ka lugar, first time pa siya nag-travel anang lugar, tapos di siya kabalo mo interpret sa mga roadway nga traffic signs, there's a possibility nga ma-accident ang resulta. But if a person, even though first time siya nga ni-travel anang roadway, but still he is very keen in terms of understanding or interpreting the roadway traffic signs, there's a higher probability that accident will not occur. We also have warning signs such as pedestrian school signs. Let us say we have pedestrian crossing ahead, be aware and stop for children crossing ahead, be aware and stop for persons with disabilities ahead, advise to pedestrian to cross at designated areas, be aware and slow down on bike lane ahead. So, naiuban nga mga motorist, bisan pag makita ni nga mga signs, pedestrian school signs, magpaturatoy regodya puno og padalagan, magpakusog og padalagan. So, may tabo, a lot of accident happens in a school zone. Why? Wala man nakita o wala na lantaw o wala ni notice ang driver sa mga pedestrian school signs. We also have railway level crossing signs. Railroad crossing vehicles must stop or give the right of way. So based on the previous discussions that I have, a motor vehicle should give the right of way sa train nga mulabang. But if in case, upon the discretion of the driver, paglantaw niya sa unahan, there is no impending danger or risk on his part, pwede siyang magpahinay 5 miles per hour. We also have railway crossing advance warning and alternative railway crossing position in an area that can be easily seen. Other warning signs are those which give caution as to the vertical clearance of a motor vehicle. So, for example, sa inyo figure na makita niya sa inyong screen, clearance is 5.20 meters, low clearance is 4.80 meters. Maximum height of a vehicle must be 5.2 meters or less. In the first figure, while maximum height of a vehicle must be 4.8 meters or less under the second illustration. So if in case there is a warning sign and a vehicle still push on going in that direction, for example, in illustration number one, my vehicle is 6 meters in height. So ang may tabo, it's either hindi siya makasulod or padasmag siya sa ang tumoy sa iyang salakyanan maigo sa ceiling. The last classification of traffic sign is what we call as guide or informative signs. These are signs that will guide the motorist or will give you information on what lies ahead. We have advanced direction signs. These signs indicate the only direction in which the motorist is obliged to follow. The next one is intersection direction signs, which is visible in less than 1 kilometer before an intersection. We also have reassurance direction signs, approximate distance of particular exit. Like say for example, Angeles, which is 70 kilometers, Baguio, which is 156. So muling mga example sa mga information signs or guide signs that will tell the motorist nga ang hilayon, gikan siyang location, padulong sa Angeles is or Baguio is 70 or 156. We also have fingerboard direction signs, provides direction to towns, tourist spots, geographic interests, and less important intersections. So if a motorist is a first-time traveler on that specific place, dili siya mawala dayon, or di siya mawala, or di na siya possibility na makaabot siya sa iyang destination simply because naa may fingerboard direction sign nga mag hatag niya direction in which way to go in order to arrive on a desired location. Another type of informative sign is the street name signs, which is very common in Negros Oriental. This informs the road users the names of the roads or streets they are passing or entering. Usually, makita nato ni in different alleys or streets in Dumaguete City, or even in other municipalities, makita nato kalagmitan ang street name signs. Next is town names and geographical feature signs. Signs that conveys the general information of interest, such as geographical locations. For example, makita nimo ang Batangas, Mountain Province, Laguna de Bay, Makati City, Pasig City, muna yung mga signs that will inform you on the specific name of a specific location. We also have service signs. So kung ang tao gigutom na o walay gasolina o ganahan siya na mupahuway sa hotel, mupunay mga different signs that will inform him on a specific distance or specific direction para ma-arrive niya ng mga location. For example, kung service center or Butangta Hospital, so na nakabutang ang letter H. Kung Kananan at the same time gasolinahan, so naapunay specific kilometers or distance nga ma-arrive niya na nga specific nga location. So kung wala kay gasolina, i-follow rin mo ni nga service nga sign. We also have tourist information and tourist destination signs. For example, in your screen, you can see Fort Santiago, Taal Lake, Scenic Lookout, National Museum, turn right, 300 meters. These are signs that will pinpoint a tourist spot. Okay? Next one, the last one is route markers, the identification and general direction of arterial roads and national highways that have significance by showing the number and direction of the route. So, moto yung mga different classification of signs or different classification of traffic signs which a motorist, which a driver should interpret once he is driving in a national or provincial roadway. Kay katong mga signs maoy magamit for him to be warned, for him to be informed, at the same time for him to be regulated on a particular provision or a particular rule on a specific location or specific place. Okay, if in case a motorist or driver will just neglect this deference sign, there is a big possibility that the driving or the journey from a place to a destination may result to either accident or fine for violation, or worse, may result to death. Another sign that must be understood by a motorist when driving are the pavement markings. Ang pavement markings will also indicate a particular interpretation or particular message. Pavement markings, they are in the form of lines, symbols, messages, or numerals, and may be set into the surface of, applied upon, or attached to the pavement. In some cases, pavement markings are used as a supplement to other traffic control devices, such as traffic signals and road signs. It simply guides traffic or gives advance warning or may impose restrictions supported by traffic regulations. So, ang kaning mga markings, muna ka itong gipanulat sa simento. Right? Nga makita ni mo, unsa may buti pasabot sa yellow line, unsa may buti pasabot sa broken yellow o solid yellow, broken white line or solid white line. So, kaniyang mga markings will also guide or will also provide messages to the motorists on what are the regulations that should be followed. If you are traversing on a national highway or provincial highway, the most common pavement marking that you can usually encounter is the longitudinal lines. These are center line or separation line. Crossing of solid white line requires special care. So meaning, muna siya mag-separate from one lane to the other. And once you cross or you will transfer to the other direction, crossing the solid white line, it has to be done in a utmost care para dili ka makadasmag sa another vehicle. Another is the lane line. Passing to the left or right is allowed provided that the way is clear. As I mentioned, or as I have discussed in the previous discussion on the salient provisions of Republic Act 4136, naay roadways nga duha, tulo, or upat kabuok ang iya nga mga lanes. Ang broken nga white nga pavement is something that separate from one lane to the other. Again, kung daghan or duha, for example, ang lanes, tapos usa lang ka direction, nila sa padulong sa Bayawan City, duha ka buok lanes, pwede ang pag-overtake sa left side, pwede po sa right side, depending on the necessity or the appropriateness of the passing or overtaking from another vehicle. Next is the barrier line. The barrier line is usually double solid yellow lines. Never cross to pass another vehicle unless permitted. So, buti pasabot sa duha ka buok nga yellow line nga solid, buti pasabot in either of the sides of the lanes na naa motor vehicles, dili siya pwede nga mo overtake. Okay? Kung solid line. Kung single solid yellow line used where overtaking from both directions are not allowed. Okay. So kung usa lang ka buok, let us say padulong sa Bayawan City, tapos na usa ka solid yellow line, ikaw pa padulong sa Bayawan City, di ka pwede nga mo overtake, tapos mukawat ka og area dire sa left side, because under the rule of law, once na ang yellow sign, di ka pwede nga mo pass sa usa ka vehicle. Gawas, kung wala na dyan sa iyong paglantaw, walay sugata o safe ang imong pagbuhat sa overtaking or passing. Another pavement markings that you can see on the roadway are broken yellow lines and broken and solid yellow lines. So if you can see broken yellow lines, this means passing is allowed. Pero broken and solid yellow lines, passing is permitted on the side of the broken line but not on the side of solid line. So unsa may buot ipasabot ani? Let us say ang imong direction sa sikat nga illustration, ang imong direction is padulong ani nga side, right? Pataas ka, paangat ang imong nga direction. Pwede ka nga maka-overtake simply because na ang imo nga sign is broken yellow line man. Okay? Naman ka sa broken yellow line. Pero kung nakadri nga side, alright? Kung nakadri nga side, tapos nakadri sa portion nga naa ang solid yellow line, dili ka pwede o di ka allowed nga overtake. Again, kung nakadri nga side sa broken yellow line, pwede ka maka-overtake, pero kung nakadri sa side sa solid yellow line, overtaking or passing is not allowed. We also have the edge line that is used to delineate the edge of the traveled way to distinguish it from the shoulder area to act as a guide past objects which are close to the edge of the pavement. So, unsa man kalagmitan ni nga pavement. Makita nimo ni nga solid siya nga white line, right? Buti pasabot, dili na ka pwedeng mulapas diri nga side simply because kani nga boundary, kani nga solid white line muni nag-create og boundary between the edge of the roadway og ang yang ginatawag og shoulder of the roadway. Next is the continuity line. It generally means that the lane you are in this ending or exiting and that you must change lanes if you want to continue in your current direction. Continuity lines on your right mean your lane will continue unaffected. So, usually makita nimo ni before sa island, right? For example, kanang roadway diha dapit sa St. Paul na island, so nakabutang ni siya ng markings. That will indicate na dili nimo siya diretso on. E kung diretso on nimo ni, madas magmangka sa island, so dapat mo change direction ka on this portion. Next is the stop lines. Vehicles are required to stop in compliance with the stop sign, traffic signals, or any other legal requirement. So, makita nimo ning stop lines in the zebra lines. Unsa man ang zebra lines? Again, muna katong mga crossroads. Usually, makita nimo ni sa mga university, high school, elementary, as long as it is a school institution, makita nimo ang zebra lines. Sa zebra lines na ang stop line. Buti pasabot, dili ka pwede nga mula pa sa stop line kay kaninga area muna ga separate sa vehicle nga side og sa pwede nga lakawan sa pag-cross sa mga pedestrian. Pero nagoy uban nga mga driver, nga gaya kay ulo, kalimitan nga ang stop nila mula pa ang ilang duha ka wheels sa front. Lapaw na padri sa tunga gagi. Mausaya pa gani bisag na traffic enforcer mo dot padulong sa zebra lines. Okay, muli ka to mga driver nga kulang kayo o disiplina. Another pavement marking is the do not block intersection. So makita usually ni in Dumaguete City, sa mga dagko nga syudad like Cebu City. These are lines which consist of yellow box within the intersection and yellow diagonal lines forming an X inside the box. The box should be open or no vehicle should stay inside the box to avoid obstruction to other vehicles. That is very understandable. So kung do not block intersection ng pavement, di ka pwede nga maghunong or mo parking drusulod sa box because that could create obstruction or traffic on the roadway. So we also have other markings that are also important when a person is traversing on a highway. We have approach markings to islands and obstructions. So makita nimo ni usually kung na ang island, as I have mentioned a while ago, makita nimo ni siya because this is usually white solid line nga ilanga gistripe. Sunod, chevron markings are often used to guide traffic into the right turning lanes separated by an island such as corner island at a signalized intersection. Rumble strips are thermoplastic lane marking designed to aid and provide motorists with visual, audio, and motion warnings on the road. Rumble strips are highly visible horizontal lines on the road that produce a humming sound and ample bumpy ride to the motorist when run over. So, naiuban nga maglibog unsa ni siya because common kayo ni. Like say for example, if you will go to the municipality of Zibulan, before muliko, naaning mudaghan kayo nga mga solid lines nga horizontal. Tapos kung agi-anay mo ni siya, it could create a bumpy movement of your motor vehicle. Naiuban kani nga mingon sila nga mao siguro na aning rumble strips kay ila pagsabot ani nanubra na ang pintal wala lang kapintalan maong di na laman gipintal muna interpretation sa uban. But ang reality di ay ang rumble strips is something that would create a humming sound, a bumpy ride, so that the motorist or the driver could be warned, okay, could be warned on the future of the road ahead. So kung likoon kayo siya like sharp curve, kung butangan niyo siya bumpy road or kaning rumble strips, ang driver ma-caution siya or ma-war simply because that could create awareness on the part of the motorist or the driver. So muna yung purpose ana nganong naa ang kaning gasunod ng mga horizontal lines na mausahay maglagot ka kay mag-bump ang imo nga motor vehicle, pero gituyo na siya para ma-warn ka sa possible nga danger sa unahan. In big cities such as in Cebu City and other big cities in National Capital Region, you can see motorcycle lane are exclusively for the use of motorcyclists to prevent from frequent change of lanes. So makita nimo kani nga sign may arrow nakamutang ang motorcycle or motorsiklo. That will signify nga pwede mo agi dire katulang mga motorcycles. Naputay ginatawag o for bicycles only. So kani ni o nga sign bone nag symbolize nga ang pwede nga mo agi dire is ang bicycle. Tapos separated siya by solid pavement nga white. That will separate sa boundary sa motorcycle sa bicycle lane o sa pikas nga lane. Lastly, we have the raised pavement markings. The raised pavement markings are the substitution of lane lines. So, katong mga highways nga walay pintal ang tunga, usually ang substitution na kanin ginatawag na to, cat's eyes, nga usually mag-glow siya during night time or musinga siya during night time. And this can also attract motorists at the same time could guide him on the proper lane nga dapat nilang di-traverse. Okay? So, ang tawag ane is raised pavement markings. So, those are the topics under traffic signs and markings which are very significant for us to become responsible drivers and motorists. Below this video, you can see the comment section. If you have questions or queries relative to the topics that I discussed a while ago, you may post your questions in the comment section and I will also respond at that section to clarify and to give unequivocal answers on the queries that you are having. Thank you so much for watching.